Ladies and gentlemen, today my subject of discussion is recognition of Israel by Pakistan. We know that with the recent recognition of Israel by Muslim states such as the UAE, Bahrain and Sudan, this thing has come to the limelight, and it is anticipated that the whole Muslim world will reverberate with the butterfly effect. Muslim states are expected to and pressurized to be falling in acceptance of Israel with dominoes. Now this power has particularly been set up by the Kushner influenced Trumpian policy in the Middle East, but still I think there are three countries in the Muslim world that are seemingly not bent on recognizing one state agenda of the Israel caused by its backers. You must know that from Pakistani side, we always go for two-state solution. We always say that land for peace, peace for land, and that is what is the demand from the Palestinian side, that they say that Israeli Palestinian recognition, and of course then there would be recognition of Israel. Now these three countries that I just mentioned include Qatar, Pakistan and Iran. In Pakistan, the ruling party, Tehreek-e-Insaf, has negotiated a lot about amongst itself for accepting the pressure or not accepting the pressure of United States as well as Saudi Arabia. And they have negated all these aspects. They always stated that they will not succumb to the pressure. And then PTI's Twitter very recently, it blatantly falsified reports going around of Pakistan, of Pakistan's tilt towards acceptance. They clearly stated no to that. Prime Minister of Pakistan also declared that country's unequivocal stance on Israel in an interview stated that it is same as that of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the founder of Pakistan in 1948, when he stated that Pakistan cannot accept Israel until Palestine gets a fair settlement that they think is right. So in terms of the process, the founder of Pakistan, Jinnah, he stated that the Muslims of India would not remain as mere spectators, and that they would help the Arabs in Palestine by all possible means. Coming back to the subject and what is happening in Pakistan at the moment is that Prime Minister of Pakistan, for him to exhibit lack of adherence to his stance would not only betray the cause of Pakistan, but also his own role in the Muslim world that he is in efforts to acquire, that is leading the Muslim world. Therefore, the manner of governance and trajectory that it has taken doesn't reflect any prospects of establishing diplomatic ties with Israel. He has acted as a leader of the Muslim world, rubbing shoulders with conservative Muslim leaders like Erdogan, like Mahathir, like Hassan Rouhani of Iran. It would be dichotomous for Imran Khan to lose his outlook. His speech in United Nations General Assembly in 2019, which was very much appreciated across the Muslim world, was reflective of his emergence as a leader of the Muslim world. The most disputed territory of Muslims is that of Palestine, followed by Kashmir, Syria, Iran, and so on. And to compromise on Palestinian land would be to compromise on the whole of the Muslim world. Yes, I can understand that the pressure from countries like United States and friendly countries like Saudi Arabia keep mounting on Pakistan, and it battles for the supremacy of the interests of Muslim world as of that. But on part of the US, pressure to recognize Israel was extraordinary during the Trump stint, as per the Prime Minister. This threat, along with other pressures, didn't deter Pakistan. Pakistan's cricketer turned Prime Minister Imran Khan, he says that he used to play well under pressure. So right now he is under pressure, and we believe that tackling a contentious situation is greeted with sportsmanship by him. That is, he would play well under this pressure. Our pressures, that is from Saudi Arabia and United States. There is another very important thing that must be kept in view, that PTI caters to the political representation of former members of the religious parties in Pakistan. It is in particularly inclusive of Jamaat-e-Islami's former members having significant say in the politics of Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf. Just for the sake of giving you an example, Dr. Arif Alvi, the president of Pakistan, has also a background from Jamaat-e-Islami. An additional factor is parties following based on a demographic that has a greater ratio of the youth. So both members of the party having religious ties and young lot are highly compassionate and emotive when it comes to Muslim solidarity. In circumstances, it would be slow suicide for the party to exhibit any such interest of abetting its Palestinian cause. Pakistan as a nation since 1948 with the creation of Israel has shown moral, legal, social, political obligation in championing the cause of Palestine. Arab wars fought in the name of Palestine have been supported with zeal in Pakistan, and therefore it is impossible for Pakistan to accept Israel without the protection of Palestinian sovereignty. And I mentioned that means a two-state solution, which means Palestine as a state, and then in return to that is recognition of Israel. Apart from whatever I stated earlier, from its deep-rooted religious commitment, Pakistan is compelled by its ethical obligation to not represent an apartheid regime and ethnic cleansing of Palestinian people. Conversely, if it were the Palestinians committing inhuman acts of violating sovereignty and mass murder of innocents, Pakistan's standpoint would have been different. Pakistan's main aim is to sue for peace and holding perpetrator, that is Israel, accountable, an objective the United Nations has failed to achieve thus far. Despite Pakistan's tainted past with human rights violations, it wouldn't bring it any closer to amend for it to stand by the side of the oppressor by granting Israel its legitimacy. Pakistan has pushed for two-state solution, as I stated earlier, forward with respect to Israel and Palestine conflict. State of Palestine, State of Israel. Israel has the slogan of peace for land, whereby they warrant peace after the acquisition of land to which they lay claim. In opposition, Pakistan draw the formula of land for peace. And that is that Pakistanis believe that in order to bring lasting peace to the region, giving back Palestinians their land is imperative, and therefore Israel shall have its peace when Palestinians shall have their land. Absence of war doesn't mean peace. Peace is uprooting of the cause of conflict in the very first place. However, if two-state solution fails to come to life, it is anticipated on the side of Israel to push a semi-autonomy status to the Palestinians with a focus on a state minus approach. The Kushner designed foreign policy of Trump office pushes forth this mandate. It is seconded by the Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu. Such a scenario will evoke clear rejections from both Palestinians and its supporters in the Muslim world, predominantly Pakistan. The recent developments in the conflict have garnered a right-based approach towards its solution as opposed to the territorial approach adopted by Israel and its backers. The realization of a one-state outcome encompassing a binational population would turn the state into a center stage of ensuing conflict and unrest. Such a front provides the necessary ingredients for disaster, rather than establishing positive peace. Thank you so much.